let us go to address. I think we are in address. Am I right? Did we finish the four reasons for finding Maurad had stolen? One is Maurad's family was basically poor. Number two, Aram knew Maurad cannot buy a horse. Number three, if Maurad cannot buy a horse, then Maurad has to steal a horse. Number four, what is that? If he had stolen a horse, I refuse it because we belong to Garoglanian family and we cannot steal, we cannot lie. Our brand character is honesty. These are the four reasons. That is why when Aram saw the horse and Maurad, he could not believe his eyes. No member of the Garoglanian family could be a thief. That is why Aram told Maurad cannot steal a horse. I stared first at my cousin and then at the horse. Maurad, horse. There was a pious stillness and humor in each of them, which on the one hand delighted me and on the other hand frightened me. Underline, one hand delighted, other hand frightened. Suppose today evening after 3 o'clock, Papa went out. And when he came back, all on a sudden, he brought a horse in front of you, white horse in front of you. And Papa was sitting on the horse. John Jose, how will you look at your Papa? You will look at Papa, horse, Papa, horse. Am I right? The same thing here, Aram. Aram was looking at Maurad, then at the horse, then at... And one sight delighted him, John Jose. When you are looking at the white horse, the sight delighted you. Oh, what a horse it is. Ah, I have a horse now. It delighted him. Second thing, it made him frightened. The way, Maurad, have you stolen it? Police will come. It frightened him. So the same scene is a scene of delight and at the same time scene of fear. Maurad, I said, where did you steal this horse from? Maurad, from where you have stolen this one? Leap out of the window, he said, if you want to ride, shut your mouth, don't make arguments, come out. Do you want to ride the horse? Shut your mouth and come out, come fast. Jump out of the window. It was true then. Now I understood, this is not a dream. This is not a dream. This is a reality because Maurad is speaking and the horse is moving. There are some people here, not India. You people are very good, excellent people. In some other class, some children are keeping their still photo as a video here. Still photo. Very beautiful, cute photo. Devi Krishna, cute photo. They think that Josie sir will not be able to know you are keeping a photo here. Josie sir is looking always at your neck. I am looking at your neck, whether it is moving or not. Isn't it? If you breathe, the neck will move. From there, I can understand that whether it is a photo or your original picture. And listen, understand. So here, till now, Maurad thought it was a dream. Morning dream, 4 o'clock. Sometimes you people also see dreams, isn't it? Like Harry Potter, you are sitting on the broomstick and you are moving in the air. Or you are together with the Alibaba and you are saying, Kulta Sim Sim, and you are entering into the cave. Morning dream. Some students are dreaming. They are sitting on the top floor of the Burj Khalifa on a revolving chair. And on their left side, there is a glass window. And from there, they are revolving their chair. And through the window, they are looking at the world. And they see. They say that, I am the chief executive of dash and dash and dash company. Clear now? There is no expense for seeing a dream. Dream, a good dream. No cost, no payment. No payment. Navreen, no payment. You can dream. You can dream. Gaya, you can dream. Sitting on the Prime Minister's chair, you can dream. No problem. No costs. Now, Aram understood it is not a dream. The horse is moving. And Maurad spoke to him. It was true then. He had stolen the horse. This is a real scene. It is true now. He had stolen the horse. There was no doubt about it. There was no question. There was no doubt about it. He had come to invite me to ride or not, as I chose. I have to make the choice. He had given me yes or no question, MCQ. MCQ. Do you want to ride or not? If you want to ride, leap out, jump out. If you do not want to ride, sleep there. It is your choice. It is your choice. Very often we choose the second one. Sleep there. Mama asks, do you have homework? Get up and do the homework. Otherwise, you sleep. What do you say? Mama, today there is no homework. Even though it is there, you say, no homework. And you get into the blanket once again. Get into the blanket once again. Tom Sidon, isn't it? We will get into the blanket once again. You see, well, it seemed to me stealing a horse for a ride was not the same thing as stealing something else such as money. Underline. Here is the change in attitude. This is what is called, in our language we say, justification. Justification. We do commit certain mistakes. We do commit certain mistakes. We do lie. We say lie, Meryl. We say lie. Not you. These people, man. Tell a lie. After saying the lie, we may justify. When we were in class 3, 4, 5, not girls, boys mainly, these naughty fellows. In the classroom, when the children are running in between the desk, what these people, Renil, what we do? We will, Renil's leg is lengthy one, isn't it? Am I right? So, he would stretch his leg there in between. What happens? The running fellow will fall down and his teeth will be on the floor. When he sees the teeth on the floor and a mouth without teeth, isn't it? Teeth on the floor and a mouth without teeth, Renil will say, oh, I did not want to hurt him. Just simply because of love, because of my friendship, I kept the leg. Because of my friendship, I kept the leg. Adulya, isn't it? This is a justification. I never thought of. Today in the newspaper, I read the news. A person who has 6 feet 2 inch height. When he walked across the MG road to Trichur, his head hit on the traffic police signboard. And he got hurt. And he told, why can't these people lift the signboard 7 feet height? Another question, why can't he see the signboard? Why couldn't he bend the head? Same question is there, isn't it? Niranjan, did you read the newspaper? In Malayalam, it is there. One picture is there. One person sitting on the chair with a handkerchief, white handkerchief with the blood. So justification. Here you see, in the previous paragraph, Aram told that we cannot steal a horse. Even if you steal a horse, I will not believe. I refuse, because we belong to Garoglanian family. We cannot steal it. We cannot tell a lie. What an enthusiasm in the words of Aram. Valentina, what an enthusiasm in the words of Aram. The next moment, because his enthusiasm and honesty was suppressed. Suppressed. Tushara, suppressed by the desire to ride the horse. So he says, taking, not stealing, taking somebody's horse to learn riding, it cannot be stealing. If you are stealing a horse and selling out and getting money, it is something dangerous. It is something guilty. It is a crime. But you see, very simple example I tell you. Rose, very simple example I tell you. We were sitting on a bench. And Rose is on my right side and I am on the left side. And I have a Parker pen with me. Very good, attractive. This is also Parker. Parker is there. I use only Parker. So Parker pen with me. So an attractive pink color. Pink color. Because why I use a pink color? Pink is for girls, isn't it? So, my Parker pen was in pink color. When Rose saw my pink pen, Rose has a desire, oh, it is a good pen, it is a good pen. I also wish to have a pink pen. A little desire, like Aram's desire to ride a horse, isn't it? So she asked me, Josie, sir, shall I write with this spirit? Then I told, okay, you write with this spirit. I gave the pink pen to write. Rose, I gave you the pen only to write during one period. Clear now? In the last period again, Rose asked me, sir, shall I write with? You write. After writing, knowingly, unknowingly, what happened? This pen fell into the bag of Rose. knowingly or unknowingly, the pen fell into the bag of Rose. Rose went home, I also went home. When I reached home, I searched my pen. Oh, it might be with the Rose. And Rose did not tell me also. Rose, what did she think? Joseph did not ask. If he had asked, I could give. Sometimes he might have thought that a letter Rose may take it. Understood? That is why he is not asking me. After 2 days, what happens? The pink pen is of Rose pen, and I am a penless man. Clear now. So when somebody asks, Rose can say, Joseph sir did not ask me, so it might be a gift of Joseph sir. I thought like that. If you want, say, I can give. Here you see, how do we make a justification? Clear now. In this way, in the previous paragraph, Aram told that a Garoglanian family member cannot steal at any cost. But his desire was suppressed by, this honesty was suppressed by his desire to ride a horse. So he wanted to ride a horse now. If he stick on his honesty, he will not be able to ride the horse. So he, in our language we say, he changed his plate. Niranjan, he changed his plate idea. Then he said, oh, taking, not stealing, taking a horse from somebody's house and ride on 1 or 2 days, it is not a crime. We cannot call it as a stealing. Clear now? You see, it seemed to me stealing a horse in this tune, you read it, stealing a horse for a ride. Understand? Stealing a horse for a ride, not to sell out, ride a horse, to ride only. I don't want your pen, I want to ride only. Clear now? So, to ride only was not the same as stealing something and selling out. For all I knew, maybe it wasn't stealing at all. What I can say, this is not a stealing. Hey, Maurad is a Garoglanian. He cannot steal. And this is not stealing at all. If you were crazy about horses, the way my cousin Maurad and I were, it wasn't stealing. You see, do you know how do we like to ride a horse? The ardent desire, the great desire. The great curiosity to ride a horse. You cannot imagine, Anila. You cannot imagine my desire to ride a horse. Aram says, such a great desire. Maurad and I that much liked to ride a horse. When we compare our desire, then 100% this is not a stealing. This is not a stealing. It wasn't stealing. It would not become stealing until we offered to sell the horse, which of course I knew we would never do. If we are selling out this horse, it is a mistake. It is a crime. It is stealing. And I am sure, 100% sure, we are not going to sell out. So we are not stealing the horse. The full paragraph says the justification of Aram about the horse, about the act of Maurad. Justification. Let me put on some clothes, I said. Now he says, reply, Maurad, wait, let me wear some clothes. All right, he said, but hurry, be hurry. be hurry. I leaped into my clothes. I leaped into my clothes. I was in a hurry to wear the clothes. I jumped down to the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse. I jumped upon the horse behind my cousin Maurath. So both were on the horse. That year, we lived at the edge of town on Walnut Avenue. Underline. They were living at Walnut Avenue. Behind our house was the country. So they were in the suburban area. Behind their house, it was countryside. How was the country? Vineyards, orchards, irrigation ditches, and country roads. Pure village, plantation, vineyards. There are, you see, vineyards. There are two types of wine. V-I-N-E wine and W-I-N-E wine. What is that? What is the difference between W-I-N-E and V-I-N-E? Yeah, both are pronounced as wine. You see, wine, vineyard. What is the difference? What is this one? Pooja, what is this one? First one. Switch on your unmute. I can't hear you. What happened? Anybody else? I can't get your voice. You see, wine is the juice of grapes. Juice from grapes. Wine and beer, board you can see, wine and beer. Alcoholic wine, pure wine, it is taken from the juice of grapes, liquid. This wine is the plant of grapes. This is the plantation or land where wine is grown, vineyards. So this is wine liquid, this is the plant. So now you see, the village or the countryside was with vineyards, orchards, fruits plantation, irrigation, ditches, canals, and country roads. In less than 3 minutes, we were on Olive Avenue, next spot, Olive Avenue, underline. From Walnut Avenue, within 3 minutes, they reached Olive Avenue. And then the horse began to trot, increased its speed. The air was new and lovely to breathe. Very pleasant air, morning time, 4 o'clock, very pleasant air, country air. No pollution, fresh air. The feel of the horse running. You see, the feel of the horse, no, feel of the horse running, sitting on a running horse. That feel was wonderful. You cannot understand. Alandina, you cannot understand. Have you on the horse? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so you know it, isn't it? You can enjoy, isn't it? Jerking and jerking and jerking and going. The feel of sitting on a horse. Once you sit, then only you will be able to understand. If you do not know, you ask Alentina, she will tell you. She will tell you. Okay. So the feel of the horse running was new, wonderful. My cousin Maurat, who was considered one of the craziest members of our family, began to sing. Urukku Thangam, isn't it? Urukku Thangam, I told one day, isn't it? Our Maurat was the Thangam of the Uru, the pearl of the village. Emeline, pearl of the village. Are you the pearl of the village? Urukku Thangam, the craziest girl of the village. So you see, Maurad was the loveliest boy of the village. And he began to sing. When are we singing? Tom Sebastian, when are we singing? When we take bath, isn't it? The whole soap will be wasted. Marie, isn't it? We will surf the soap, and at that time all the songs will come. Devi Krishna, all the songs will come, isn't it? Surfing and surfing and singing and singing and singing. So when Maurad was riding the horse in great speed, he began to sing. That means he was enjoying the riding. I mean, not singing. He was roaring. Loud voice he was singing. Every family has a crazy streak in it. Crazy streak. A crazy desire in it somewhere. And my cousin Maurad was considered the natural descendant of the crazy streak in our tribe. In all the tribes, in all the families, in your language, in all the Tharavads, isn't it? Tharavads. Grandparents, grandfather, father, son, and we and the coming generation, the whole family line is there. And for each and every family line, there would be a particular nature common to all. He is just like his father. She is just like her mother, grandmother. Deshimi is on the tumbat of the mook, isn't it? Deshimi is on the tumbat of mook. Anger is on the tip of the nose. Mary, understood? Tumbat of the mook, isn't it? Her grandmother was so angry. Like she also. I am not saying any name. Every family member has a streak, a particular nature of the family members, forefathers. In the same way, here Maurad had also a streak, a line of thought of his tribe. You see, before him was our uncle Khosro, underline. Before him was our uncle Khosro, an enormous man. A fatty fellow, bulky, sulky fellow, like myself, isn't it? Bulky, sulky fellow. So fatty fellow was with a powerful head of black hair. Black hair. And the largest mustache in the San Joaquin Valley. In the San Joaquin Valley, Uncle Khosro had the longest mustache. It falls up to the chest, falling into the chest, on the chest, longest one. And he was a typical man. A man so furious. You see, a caricature of Khosro is made. He is an enormous man with the powerful, thick black hair. Then, largest mustache of the countryside. A man so furious in temper. Anger is on the tip of the nose. Anger was on the tip of the nose. So irritable. Very good character, isn't it? Don't follow him. Very good, a model person. So irritable. So impatient. No patience. Impatient, that he stopped anyone from talking by roaring, "It is no harm. Pay no attention to it." Many films have a title song, and something like that, isn't it? Films have title songs. Those who like films, how many are here like title songs? Rose, do you like films? No, sir, isn't it? Rose likes film songs, isn't it? Many film songs are title songs, isn't it? Am I right? Even though you don't like, I think there is something like that, isn't it? I am a person who does not watch films. I don't watch films. That is why I don't know. That is why Alice will be able to tell me, isn't it? Title songs, isn't it? Alice never leaves any movie in Ayur Devi Theatre, isn't it? Ayur, it is Devi Theatre, which is the name of the, what is the name of the theatre there in Ayur? Oh, near the junction, there is one theatre. I know. What is the name of the theatre? Oh, how innocent she is. She does not know the name of the theatre. Theatre is not there near the church. Theatre is there. I know the place. That is why I am asking you. So title song. In this way, there is a title caption for Uncle Khosro. What he says, even though the house is burning, even though you lose, you are in ICU, Uncle Khosro says, "No problem, no problem, don't pay attention." Today, open surgery, heart is to be, no valve for the heart, very serious surgery. Uncle Khosro says, no problem, don't give attention to that. That is his title saying. Whatever happens, he says, "It is no harm. Pay no attention to it." That was all. No matter what anybody happened to be talking about, once it was his own son, Arak, his own son, Khosrow's son, Arak, running 8 blocks, you can say 8 furlong, 8 blocks to the barber's shop, distance, 8 furlong, where his father, Uncle Khosro, having his mustache trimmed, this is very lengthy, he was getting it trimmed. To tell him, his son ran to him to tell him their house was on fire. Khosro's house was on fire. And his son came to him to tell him, "Papa, our house is on fire." This man, Khosro, sat up in the chair and rode. He was sitting on the barber's chair and he rode. "It is no harm. Pay no attention." To the son, he told, his own house is burning. So he told, "Brah, it is no harm. Let it burn. No harm." That was his nature. The barber said, "But the boy, Khosro,
Do you understand? The boy says, your own house is burning.
So Khosrow roared,
hey, shut up.
It is no harm. Pay no attention to it. You see?
I told you,
pay no attention. It is no harm. So here in two paragraphs, the author brings out the nature of Uncle Khosrow, a particular person with a character. Okay. The rest we will see in the next class. Okay. Thank you.